the Virginia Department of Emergency Management came to us and said that they needed training for emergency services personnel to operate small unmanned aerial systems.
Unmanned aircraft system technology has changed the landscape of how we operate as public safety responders, in that it allows us to get a bird's eye view. That means we can understand what's happening not only in front of us, but around us very quickly, which helps to make better decisions in an emergency situation. The Certificate of Authorization, or COA, that Piedmont received is really the first in the country to be able to do research and development as well as potential night flying.
The public agencies, law enforcement, fire and rescue, search and rescue members, they spend a lot of time on training. And to disregard that high level of training when it comes to a UAS, just because they're easy to fly doesn't mean that that same level of training shouldn't be applied. They need to be proficient in the operation and its application as well. It needs to be a tool, not just a toy. Compare it to a fire truck. Get your driver's license at 16, but if you want to be a fire truck driver, you have to go through more advanced training. Yeah, there's plenty of toy drones out there that you can fly and practice and play around with, but to apply them to a scenario, an incident response, that requires specialized training. For the most part, the training that we're giving the public agencies is also being taught to Part 107 operators in the commercial environment. So we're going to carry that over, and PVCC will start offering advanced courses in precision agriculture, aerial cinematography and videography, aerial surveying and mapping. And the workforce that is around our region, cell phone tower inspectors, energy infrastructure, building inspectors, civil engineers, they all could benefit from having a UAS.
I think Piedmont has really offered quite a unique opportunity to allow responders and technologists in unmanned aircraft systems to come together to determine what is the right curriculum for an operational setting. And from that standpoint, it's a phenomenal opportunity for an insight and practical experience from this course.